Hello, my beautiful ladies. It's Greta here, ladies relationship coach. And today, my beauties, I'm going to talk about hot and cold games men play on women. And I will give you three examples of those games. Initially, I was actually thinking of doing a video about hot and cold games that you could play on men. However, as I was thinking more about it, to be able to pull off a hot and cold game and look genuine with it, and looking genuine, it's the only way that works. It takes skill and practice. And if you will, you know, if I would do a video on that and then you girls would actually take it the wrong way, it could actually really damage your relationship. So I was just thinking, you know what, girls, I'm not risking with that. Let me just give you the examples of hot and cold that men play with women. So you are aware of it. And when the guy is playing those games on you, it does not affect you. And you just basically let him have his tantrum. And if you react to it in a high value way, his attraction towards you will only increase. So game number one, and I see this happening a lot. It's very, very common nowadays. So what happens is the guy takes you on a date. He sweeps you off your feet. You have lots of fun time together. He's very charming. You feel like you're falling heads over heels in love. And basically after the date, he pulls away, or he starts giving you only breadcrumbs through text messaging. So the reasons for that could be, first, he's, let's say, very, very busy. He's very goal oriented and he just doesn't have time for texting. So he just stays in touch with you through messages. And when he sees you again, he sweeps you off your feet again. You have an incredible time together again. Or the second reason could be that he is playing games, which is, he wants to make you insecure during the text messages, so you would pursue him and you would be chasing him. Now, the wrong way to behave in this is to get insecure and start to chase and pursue him when he kind of pulls away through during his, let's say, the cold period. So if you will start to pursue him and chase him, he will feel like, okay, this girl is hooked on me already. She's pursuing me like crazy. She's into me like crazy. And his attractions for you will start to fade away. So what you do is, doesn't matter what his intention is. Is he just busy and he doesn't have time to text you, so he's just keeping in touch? Or is he playing a hot and cold game? It really doesn't matter what he is doing. The key, what matters, is how are you behaving to this. So the high value way to behave to this, if he is giving you breadcrumbs and he's giving you a tiny bit of attention, you give him a tiny bit of attention back. Okay, so you don't ignore it. You don't become too bitchy. Oh, this is not good enough. He replied to my story with an emoji. I'm not replying to that, or I'm gonna tell him off for only giving me breadcrumbs. No, this is too bitchy. It doesn't work. Or the other way is you chasing him and pursuing him, showing how much you're into him. That's acting dormant-y, that's acting sad, that's putting the guy first, that's looking desperate. It doesn't work either. But what does work is when he, let's say, texts you and gives you a little bit of attention, you respond to it politely, and then you wait for him to text you again, and then again you respond to it politely. Even if he just drops you a picture message or a link, it's still good to respond to it. Like, even responding just with one emoji, it's better than ignoring it. Okay, like for example, if you would send a link to a guy or a picture to the guy and he just ignores it, would you like it? No, you wouldn't. So, you know, if he's giving you a breadcrumb, still acknowledge it. Just don't over acknowledge it. Give him thumbs up or an emoji. That's more than enough. The hot and cold game number two is breaking the pattern. So, for example, if every single morning he texts you good morning, or during an evening he texts you good night. And then one morning he doesn't text you good morning, or one evening he doesn't text you good night. I see a lot of girls getting insecure over it, and we go like, oh my God, Greta, every single morning he texts me good morning and today he didn't text me. What's happening? Does he not like me anymore? Is he losing interest? You know, girls get very insecure and we get paranoia and we overthink it and so on. So this is actually a very good way that you ladies could use as well to break the pattern a little bit, to keep the guy a bit more on his toes. So if every single morning you text him, you reply to his good morning text, and one morning you don't reply to it, and you, let's say, reply to the good morning text in the evening, and you say, instead of good morning, you say good night, because let's say you've been so busy, you're keeping a guy a little bit more on his toes and you're changing the pattern. Okay, so disrupting the pattern makes people a little bit more on the edge, a little bit more insecure. Keeping somebody a little bit insecure on their toes sometimes can benefit you, because this is when that person starts realizing their feelings for you. Because when every single morning you're getting a good morning text, you're getting that reassurance and you're like, oh, he texts me good morning again, or oh, she texts me good morning again, yeah, whatever. But when you don't get that good morning text, then you're like, oh my God, does she not like me? Does she not love me? When you start overthinking it, when you start to create a bit of paranoia in your head. And this is when you actually realize that you have feelings for that girl or the guy. Okay? So ladies, if you want to do this to the guy, it's okay to do it sometimes. And if the guy is doing it to you, do not worry about it. Just the next time he texts you good morning or good night, just respond to it and that's it. There is nothing wrong going on. He's just trying to break the pattern a bit to keep you a bit more on your toes. That's it. So really, like, calm down about it. Don't overthink it. Everything is good. Then called game number 3 that guys play on women. So it's a bit of a funny one and it's a proper game. So let's say you have a boyfriend or you're meeting up with your date, and every single time when you meet up, he sweeps you off your feet, he's charming, he tells you how much he loves you, how crazy he is about you. He's always holding your hand, he's always trying to touch you, he's showing his affection, attention. You're basically, he's treating you like a queen, right? And for example, you meet him today and he is cold, he doesn't give you a hug when he sees you, he doesn't give you a kiss when he sees you, throughout the whole day he doesn't touch you, he doesn't give you compliments, he doesn't give you any affection. He's just basically doing his own thing and walking cold as ice, okay? So why is he doing that? But basically pushing your buttons to make you insecure. What do you do in this case? If every single time you meet up with your boyfriend, and as I said, he totally sweeps you off your feet, and let's say today you met up with him and he is, you know, he doesn't lean towards a kiss, he doesn't lean towards a hug, he's just being very cold, you know, he's got a bit of this kind of thing going on. You see this energy straight away and you go like in your head, is this the game we're playing today? Okay. And you basically play him at his own game. So if he's not leaning towards a hug, if he's not leaning towards a kiss, if he's not being affectionate, you're doing the same back. You're not getting insecure. You get on your phone, you call your girlfriend, you call your mom, your dad, your friend, your sister, brother, cousin, whatever, but whoever you want to call. You can spend that day with him, but you're just kind of busy and not paying any attention to his cold as ice kind of attitude, showing that it's not affecting you at all, that you're a confident girl and that you're totally not insecure about this. when he will drop you home, or when after the date you're gonna go home, I bet you the next day he's gonna be texting you like crazy, telling you how much he loves you. Because mirroring his behavior and not pursuing him, his game is going to backfire and he is the one who will get insecure. Because he will see that him being a cold iceberg is not affecting you. And he will be like, why is it not affecting her? Does she not love me anymore? Is she not that into me? Why is she not getting upset? So therefore, the next day he's gonna be showing his emotions and he will start pursuing you like crazy again. Okay, so this is how you ladies handle their hot and cold games. Ladies, if you would like to know more games that guys play on women, please check out this video just by clicking on this little link right here. If you liked this video, please press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please let me know what did you think of it in the comments below. Join my high value women group where we are all in the same boat, learning how to be a woman of high value and bring out the best in our men. Join my Instagram, which is called Ladies Relationship Coach. I do Instagram lives where weekly answering your free questions during my Instagram lives. And if you would like to get one-on-one coaching, please book me as a coach through my website so I can hold your hand and help you to bring out the best in your man so he treats you like a queen, values, cherishes, respects you, and loves you to the moon and back, as they say. And thank you so much for watching again. Kisses from London. Mwah.